Actually, this is a cathode ray tube, and I'm going to explain J.J. Thompson's cathode ray tube experiment further. So, J.J. Thompson, according to J.J. Thompson, the materials move through the anode. So, let's say you have an anode. Anode straight through the anode, a hole in the anode, there's a hole in. So, straight through it, and it was seen on the zinc sulfide fluorescent screen as a goal. So, let's take this as our zinc sulfide fluorescent screen. Okay. So that's our first point. Point A, it was seen as a zinc sulfide fluorescent screen. So the cathode ray tubes moved straight and they were deflected by both magnetic and electric plates, and so seen as point B on the zinc sulfide fluorescent screen as a glow. So if there was the rays were passing through, you'd have seen there will be a small light on the screen then to just disperse. That's the way the cathode ray tube experiment is all about. So that's J.J. Thompson's cathode ray tube experiment. He made three observations. He said even when the materials were changed, they all behaved the same. This shows that this shows more about his experiment that is true, and they are all seen as a glow on the zinc sulfide fluorescent screen too. And this is the magnetic side and the electric side. I've just removed that side. I'll show it to you guys in my next video. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment to my YouTube channel.